Hey guys, what's up? We're having a look at this all new Ford Ranger. And for me, it's all new. It's my first opportunity to drive this Ranger. So I've been looking forward to that. And it's an interesting piece. We'll get into that. But as well, this particular Ranger offers an interesting opportunity to see how these Rangers are holding up with some miles. This particular press unit, this tester from Ford, has over 9,000 miles, and I'm very interested to see how it's holding up. If you're new to the channel or you haven't seen my pieces before, I'm Brian Max, accomplished racing driver, been driving trucks since I was a kid, and absolutely love these things because I do use them from time to time, whether it's, you know, towing, hauling, or whatever the case is. So join me as we have a look at this well-miled Ford Ranger. What's also interesting is that during my test, the weather's gone from pleasant to decidedly unpleasant, if you can see that snow out there, but that's given me the opportunity to try the four-wheel drive system, so we'll talk about that in a bit. But I do have a number of things to say about the powertrain. The engine works great, and in fact, it's modestly efficient, but what really makes the powertrain is the 10-speed automatic, and in normal driving, it's always trying to get into a higher gear and really rely on the torque, that low RPM torque of the 2.3 turbo. You can drop it into this sort of sport mode that will hold gears a little bit longer. And there is, of course, manual control of the gears if you so desire. But what I find is in regular driving, it's always trying to shift to that higher gear. Like, for example, we're cruising along at like 50 miles an hour and we're not even 2000 RPM. So thankfully, there's plenty of torque here. As I lean into the throttle, it'll drop down a couple of gears and that's fine. What I do find in around town driving, for example, for some reason, and it may be due to the testing abuse perhaps of this particular unit, but what it seems to do is be reluctant to really go from second to third, and it just likes to hold on to or second a little bit longer than it should, and from time to time it lurches a little bit. I don't know if that's from the testing that this poor unit has suffered or if that's a characteristic of the 10-speed, but that's one thing that it does do from time to time. On the other hand, shifts are very smooth and almost imperceptible, and for the most part, this transmission is pretty flawless. There is that ongoing issue that I found with this particular car with that reluctant second to third shift, but otherwise I don't mind this 10-speed at all. One thing I haven't done is driven this Ranger with any particular load, but in regular unladen driving, what I don't care for is the suspension damping. The shocks just don't seem to be calibrated perfectly here. There's just not enough body and wheel control, and there's a lot of secondary motion after you hit an impact on the road. If you like that sort of thing, I just want a little bit more control. But if you like a really soft ride with that ongoing continual motion, well, that's fine. It's not for me. I just like a little bit more control of the body and each wheel as the truck goes over impacts. On the other hand, that softer ride does make for a more relaxing driving experience, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, especially if you are taking your Ranger on a longer road trip. It is a very comfortable place to be. On the other hand, goes over impacts quite easily, and that's perhaps the trade-off. Certainly speed bumps or other road imperfections, it does a great job absorbing those, and certainly the larger tires help with that as well. The interior is a very typical Ford affair. It's very straightforward, very simple, and that's great because you've got all the information you need, all the controls are in the right places, whether that's primary, secondary, tertiary control, everything is in the right place and everything works as it's supposed to. There's nothing unusual about that, and Ford does a great job with that. In terms of the cabin size, it's more than big enough. I can actually fit behind myself in the back, and it's quite comfortable back there. There is a bit of adjustability to the seat. You can lift it up for stowing larger items in that second row. One thing that I was expecting is to find a damped tailgate out there, and that's not the case. The tailgate just, you know, drops right down, but that's not the case, at least in this trim level. I have absolutely zero complaints about seating position and visibility. There's more than enough adjustability in the seat and the steering column to get comfortable, and I'm seated at the lowest position of seat travel, and I can see perfectly in every direction. And of course, when I'm parking, that backup camera makes things a little easier. Even the seat is comfortable enough and supportive enough for long road trips, and overall, cabin comfort is excellent, top-notch, and I haven't had any complaints from any passengers. As I've mentioned, I've driven this mostly in two-wheel drive high, but I've needed to use four-wheel drive high as well, and this controller makes things very easy. The shift from two high to four high is almost instantaneous. Once it's in four-wheel drive, traction is exceptional, and we are on the original equipment tire. We're not on a winter tire. The four-wheel drive system has done a fantastic job here in some deeper snow. Thankfully, it's been my privilege to drive this in a bit of snow. For this being a 2020 model year vehicle, the adaptive cruise is or leaves a lot to be desired. There's no low speed follow. It seems to shut off around 25 miles an hour. If you do the sort of driving that I do in traffic jams and that sort of thing, there is no low speed follow. On the other hand, the adaptive cruise control does work exceptionally well, totally reliable. Except, of course, in weather like this, because the sensors are now blocked, and the ranger has told me that adaptive cruise is not available.
On this channel, I normally don't cover fuel consumption, but I figured you guys might be interested in this, so let me tell you. During my test, in 225 miles of driving, I averaged 15.6 miles per gallon in mixed driving. That was mostly city and a little bit highway.
With respect to this Ranger having over 9,000 miles, I will say it is holding up exceptionally well. The finish, the interior, it does look like a brand new vehicle, and it rides, drives much like a brand new vehicle. There really aren't any compromises. So it's interesting to see that, you know, after so many miles in the hands of automotive media, that it's still in exceptional shape, and that speaks to the durability of the materials that Ford has chosen, both inside and out. This Ranger, like I said, looks absolutely brand new, and I would have expected it to have a little bit of signs of wear and tear, and that's not the case. So Ford's done a great job specifying all these materials, because again, looks brand new at over 9,000 miles. As well, with a press unit like this, I would expect at this kind of mileage a little bit of flutter from the front brake rotors, but no, that's not the case. The front brakes are top notch, and brake pedal feel is just like a brand new vehicle. So Ford has done a fine job building this, and based on what I'm seeing with this over 9,000 mile unit, I'd expect the Ranger to be very, very durable in the long run. With, you know, Rams and Jeeps, there's a bit of whimsy there because they love putting their Easter eggs throughout those vehicles. With a Ford, there's none of that. This Ranger is absolutely perfectly straightforward, and sure, you know, the truck is enjoyable to drive, but there are no joyful surprises with this Ranger. It is a straightforward mid-sized truck. Overall, very impressed with this, and certainly impressed with the durability of this Ranger, particularly this one being at over 9,000 miles, and those are hard miles with automotive media driving these things. So it's nice to see this thing holding up, and I've definitely seen worse at this kind of mileage, and Ford's done a nice job, you know, speccing these materials, because they have held up for some serious abuse, and it's nice to see. thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this all-new Ford Ranger. Hope you liked this piece, and if you did, well, you know what to do. You're not new on YouTube. And if you have any questions for me, you can reach out on my social, links here, links below, and feel free to leave any questions in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time.